The Sanderson Farms Championship will have a new look and feel this year due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Mandatory face masks and social distancing are some major changes.
A lot of cleaning this week, a lot of hand sanitizing stations all over the course, you know, both for our volunteers and for our players and all the vendors.
It took a lot of changing. It's there's always been a way we've done it, and this year we've had to switch it up, and that's always chaotic, but we've got it handled very well.
The John Soul's Foods Pro-Am teed off Monday. Instead of enjoying the action in person, spectators must watch it from afar.
Well, there won't be any fans, so that'll be very different, and you won't be allowed to roam around. You go to you check in and you go to your spot, do your job, and then you leave. So I feel like it won't be quite as fun, you know, to roam around, see people you know.
Every entry has temperature checks, including Christ United Methodist Church, which is the location for volunteer and media shuttles.
Checking at this site specifically with a thermal camera to see if anybody that comes in is over the CDC recommended fever temperature of 100.4. If they are, they're pulled aside to go through secondary screening.
Although there are fewer volunteers this year, organizers say there are a lot more shuttle buses.
We want everybody to social distance on our shuttle buses, so we've added buses onto the route. We're cleaning those every hour.
Golfers and volunteers are among those who ride the shuttle buses to the Jackson Country Club all throughout the day. Tico Steakhouse is a shuttle location for caddies. In Jackson, Shalika Powell, 16 WAPT News.